you have resources, especially solar PV on the houses in that neighborhood, and the electricity grid that can provide wind, solar, hydropower, etc., etc. But you can also import by pipeline or ship renewable hydrogen from elsewhere, from further away, and bring it into your system. And then with electrochemical conversion technologies, and that is the electrolyzer and the fuel cell, you can convert the excess electricity, for example, in hydrogen, and fuel it into a hydrogen grid. And when you have a shortage of electricity, then you can, of course, import it from the grid, or you can use a fuel cell, a stationary fuel cell installed in the neighborhood, or the fuel cells in the car or in the houses. Of course, you can use your batteries that have the similar structure, because you can place a battery, stationary battery, in the neighborhood, or use your cars, your battery electric cars, or use the battery, the home batteries, to get some electricity out of it. And in the end, you can store in these batteries, of course, especially for day and night, and in hydrogen in these salt caverns, especially for the seasonal storage. And therefore you will have in such a neighborhood not only an electricity grid in the end, but an electricity and a gas grid. And if there is an existing area, you don't need to expand the capacity in your electricity grid. The only thing that you have to do is converting the gas grid into a hydrogen grid, which is already there. So in the end, a smart integrated control and optimization is needed, not only for an electricity grid, but for a combination of an electricity and a hydrogen grid. A smart symbiosis, as I have said in my title. And with that, we can realize an affordable, reliable, clean, but also an inclusive energy system.